really the great metaphor of this particular movie is about the demise of empathy, and you know, when you see a character like Caesar not being able to hold back from his own personal rage and his own personal grief and become full of hate, then we're in a bad place.
The war between humans and apes escalates. The Planet of the Apes franchise is looking to be the big blockbuster hit this weekend, and movie writer Mike Scott with NOLA.com, the Times-Picayune, joins us with what will be everybody's pick for the movie that is least most watched, to see how it does at the box office.
Yeah, absolutely. This one will win the box office as far as the new releases, and it's probably going to give Spider-Man a run for its money as the top overall movie at the box office. This one is the third in a trilogy that started a few years ago, a trilogy reboot. And basically, the story this time is set 15 years after the first movie. Our suddenly intelligent apes are now living in Northern California, kind of want to be left alone. But Woody Harrelson plays a militant human who really is disinclined to leave them alone, setting up the action for the movie. And this one really is getting rave reviews at this point. You can expect some great visual effects, including the apes in the movie. You can expect some great action. You can expect some great performances, including from Andy Serkis, who you saw at the top there.
Who plays Caesar, the leader of the apes.
He plays a chimp, and every time he does a motion capture performance, he sort of raises the bar on what we can expect. Motion capture performances. So this, like I said, the reviews on this one are great. And what it does is something incredible. This is the rare trilogy that is able to maintain the momentum for all three installments.
Well, that's fascinating, because I know you are not a fan of sequels in general.
In general, because most sequels are pale in comparison to the spark of creativity that started the original. This one, however, has stuff to say, which always elevates.
And a great case of where in this case Andy Serkis raises, you could have put the wrong actor in that role and ruined the whole movie.
Absolutely. He's really like our preeminent motion capture actor. He did Gollum in The Lord of the Rings. He did King Kong in the King Kong movie, and of course Caesar here.
All right, a couple more movies for those who maybe aren't into talking monkeys. or monkeys with a brain. Obit, which is really a movie about more than one Obit.
Right, yeah. War of the Planet of the Apes is going to win the box office, but there are a couple of smaller independent movies that are worth seeing. Obit is one of them. It's a documentary about the obituary writing team at the New York Times. Now, I'm a newspaper geek, so of course I love it, but I don't think you have to be a newspaper geek to like this movie. It's interesting, it's light viewing, it's an easy watch, just to see how they approach their craft of what most people in the newsroom would see as a very difficult job.
No, Mike, you're a dot-com freak, remember. All right, so it's the digital age. All right, and then the other one takes us inside a convent.
Right, this is a R-rated medieval comedy. You don't see too many of those. It's actually based on the Decameron, and it tells the story of a group of naughty nuns and the hunky handyman who is hired on to help around the convent in ways that he can't imagine when he gets hired on. And this is one of those movies that you're not going to find yourself falling out of your chair laughing, but it's amusing throughout. It feels like an SNL skit writ large with a little bit of Monty Python thrown in. And really what works is the great cast here.
Okay.
You've got a great cast, Aubrey Plaza, John C. Reilly, Dave Franco, the list goes on and on, and they elevate the material. It's just a lot of fun.
All right, Mike Scott, you made me want to see that one.